Bootleg Kev, you came a long way from selling me them bum-ass DVDs that didn't work.
My man, you still remember that Boise, Idaho shit?
Hey, man, I want my money back, man.
I know. I probably owe you about $25, gang.
You owe me $25. I want my money back before we... I want you to say you're going to give me my money back full refund before we start any interview.
All right, yo, gang. When you come into Phoenix for this powerhouse, I'm going to give you that money back, or I'm going to give you some movies that work.
I want my money back, and then we can start fresh talking about the movies after you get my money.
All right, and by the time you get out here for Powerhouse, 2K13 will be out, so maybe we'll just get it in on some 2K13 and call it even if I win.
Go, and I know you're gonna play me. You're probably gonna play me with a bootleg Xbox controller, one of the Mad Cats.
No, I'll play you with a bootleg team, the Phoenix Suns.
Yeah. Oh, there you go. They
gonna
win with them.
My man, it's Power 98.3 live on the phone. My good friend, we have got the game. What's up, brother?
Hey, man, I'm chilling, man. Well, people in Phoenix don't know, man. Me and Bootleg Kev are actually real friends. You know, some of y'all might think it's Bootleg Kev is like a radio personality name, but no, Bootleg Kev really has the bootlegs, and if the feds are listening, then, go pick them up, because it's serious.
We just announced this morning, Powerhouse, you are headlining, my brother, so we are going to be doing it real big November 16th, man. We cannot wait to get you back out here to AZ.
Hey, man, I mean, I'm Jesus piece. Who else is going to headline? If it wasn't me, it would have to be God.
Of course, man. So, hey, let's talk about Jesus piece. You, I'm actually very happy because the last album, we had to wait a while to get the Red album. It seems like this album is quite the turnaround from the last one, so you ain't leaving your fans waiting too long. Let's talk about Jesus Peace, man. What can we expect from it?
Hey, yo, you can expect Jesus Peace to, topple every other album that will come out in the next 2 years, man. Jesus Peace is going to set a new precedent for how hip-hop albums are recorded from now until probably I'm done rapping, man. Kool & Dre, executive producer, man. Khaled, assistant. My homeboy Stat Quo is co-executive producer with me. Everybody's on the album, from Nas to Weezy to Ross to 2 Chainz, like, to Meek Mill. Like, the album is just retarded, dude. And I mean, you know me, I'm real conceptual with my albums. I got that from Nas early on in my career, man. But this album is nothing short of a classic, and everybody keeps saying documentary, too. I don't like to do that, but that's just the talk around here, man.
Yeah, because in my opinion, you got 2 classic albums, man. I actually like Doctor's Advocate more than the documentary, personally.
Hey, that's what I tell people. I always tell people that Doctor's Advocate was my best album.
I agree with you, but that's, of course, not to say, because I think you're one of the few artists that has never put out, a lot of artists have that one black mark on their discography, and I think all your albums are dope. What is the reason for naming it Jesus Piece?
The reason for naming it Jesus Piece is... I had my album title was 5, and then Trey Songz, my good buddy Trey Songz, he stole my album title and came with Chapter 5. I talked to Trey Songz about it, and I made him do a hook on Jesus Piece to make up for him stealing my album title, and so he agreed, and we laughed about it. But I had a song on 5 called Jesus Piece with Kanye on it. And so once I started looking for a new album title, I just, made a Jesus Piece, because I already had that song with Ye. And I scrapped all the songs from 5, and in the last 3 weeks, I've completed my new album with all new tracks and all the features of it and everything. And it's ready for you to bootleg, Kev.
You got to talk to these R&B singers, dog. Tell them to stop stealing your album titles, man. Tell Neo and Trey they got to fall back.
It's all good, man. They do it in good taste, man. At least they stealing from the right guy.
Right. Ayo, so the Celebration record is bananas. We haven't had a record that we've put out on the air. I mean, we were on it. Right. I know Power 106 had the exclusive for a few days on that joint, but we had it pretty early, man, and it's the phone lines for that record are crazy, dog. Whose idea was it to sample Bone, man?
Of course that was my idea, man. I've been wanting to sample that Bone Thugs First of the Month for like my whole career, and I finally got, a guy or a team that could do it, and my homie Sap and Kool & Dre. They did it, and I sent it to Weezy first. He killed it, then I played it for Chris, and he got on the hook, and then Tiger and Wiz fell in line after that. So, I mean, the record's dope. It's out there flying, man. I appreciate the PHX for holding me down, man. It's West Side or Die.
Documentary is one of those albums to where I remember when it came out. I remember where I was at when I bought it. I remember what store I bought it. You know what I'm saying? I remember when I went and picked up that album. What is, like, one of those albums that you remember as a kid, man, just like vividly remember when and where you bought it, like a classic old school hip hop album?
The classic old school hip hop album for me was probably Quick as the Name, man. I remember I bought Quick as the Name in the Lakewood Mall, and I went and got my mom out of Nordstrom, and I told her, you know, because back then, you know, you couldn't buy an album if you was a kid when it had the parental advisory sticker.
Yeah.
So I got my mom. I think my mom was trying to buy a new washing machine and dryer set. I went and pulled her all the way down to the Sam Goody, and I made her buy the album, and she was like, "Well, what is this?" I was like, "Well, you know, his name is DJ Quick. He's young. He's from Compton, like me, and he's, you know, he's making good music for kids like me." And as soon as we got in the car, I put it on. The first words out of his mouth was "Black." My mom reached in the back seat and she slapped the fuck out of me, man. And yeah, so there was my experience with hip hop.
That is crazy. That's the worst luck. Black pussy's the first thing she heard on the joint. That's hilarious. Hey, oh, man, I wanted to talk to you, man.
Hey, hold on. I was censoring myself. I didn't know we could say black pussy.
We pre-recorded right now, so we can say pussy all we want. Oh, we just gonna bleep that
pussy,
shit.
Black pussy, black pussy.
My man, hey, of course, I've been a big fan of yours, man. I remember when I got the Fifth Element mixtape, brother. I mean, I was like blown away, man. I think the first time I heard you, I believe it was on a joint with Fabolous. I might be wrong, but
that Blister in the Compton, man.
You know, that period of your career when you were, you know, steadily dropping the G-Unit radios and you were on that mixtape circuit when mixtapes were really, you know, mixtapes. Now it's almost like they're albums. Back then it was, you know, it just had a different feel. Do you miss that time period? I mean, I know that you and 50 have had your differences and that, you know, of course you guys don't fuck with each other, clearly, but do you ever miss that? Because at that point in time, it was almost like you guys were like the 92 Dream Team of hip-hop. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But you know what, man? I'm like, you know, I was like the Bobby Brown, man, the Ralph Tresvant, man, in that group, man. So, nah, I don't miss that, man. I'm doing my own thing, man, and I always wanted to be a solo artist. It was Dr. Dre and Jimmy Iovine's idea to throw me in a group, and I think that it helped me, you know, at the time. But I'm glad that I've been solo, man. It's you know, the money is better when it's just you, man.
And
you
and to be fair, you did your you know, no matter what anybody ever says, you have made history on your own, and you also were a part of history, you know, with G-Unit. You know what I'm saying? Because when you were a part of G-Unit, right. G-Unit was at its peak, and you know when you left, it just slowly kind of declined. You know what I'm saying? So
right.
All right, well, Game Dar, I appreciate you checking in, brother. I know you always get the video games early, bro. You got that 2K13 yet?
Man, I get the 2K13 on Monday, man. And, you know, I'm already, we good. We got Dwight Howard, man, and Steve Nash, Kobe, Artest, and, you know, and Gasol, man. So I don't know if Phoenix is going to be, you know, stand a chance.
I'm going to say this, man. I know you, and I've seen you while all the Black Wall Street entourage is out, you know, hollering at females and getting drunk and doing what they do. I promise you, this dude Game, if he's on tour in a city, he will be in his hotel room, not worried about none of that BS. He'll be on that online, on them sticks, kicking some ass one time.
You know what it is, man. I done messed up a lot of money, man, playing Xbox, man.
My dude. All right, yo, Game, man, we gonna see you. The tickets are on sale right now, $20. Powerhouse is happening. The game is headlining. It's gonna be crazy. Thank you for the call, my G.
Hey, yo, everybody get your tickets, man. I'm gonna come through, shut it down one time for the city, and keep Jesus Peace on your mind. The dopest hip hop album in a long time is coming soon. Bootleg Cab, you my brother, I love you, man. I'm out here, Mike.
All right, bro.